Hello. So today we have Toshiba. It's a kind of old laptop and tiny. It's 13.3 inch. It's a Toshiba Portage R830. Okay. So what's the problem? Is not starting and it only flash this LED power LED. So let's begin to it flash 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2. There's 3, 3, 2. Okay, that sequence. And he doesn't do anything when I press on the power on. Okay. I suspected that was a battery problem, battery blocking, not detecting and blocking somehow. I seen this kind of behavior, but is not the case. So 3, 1, 2, 3, and 2, 1, 2. You see? So it's not a battery problem. So it's on it's a problem from main board. So let's disassembly. The screw and the screw missing. They are missing. We have a copper foil. Awesome. Like in old good old times, you know. So here we have the DDR3 2 GB. Of course, it's a normal normal tension, not a low version. And this is 4 GB. So we have 6 GB. Okay, that's awesome. We have here an SSD. And I don't know how to open. Okay, like this. That's nice. Okay, it's on a crucial 256 GB, and let's see now. Without memory, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Yeah, exactly the same behavior. Exactly the same behavior. Okay. So let's disassembly. I never disassembly this model in my career. So that's the first. This is missing. Yeah, it's missing. So like the all of old notebook, this one has a lot of screw, which is a good idea because laptop it's a sturdy, it's a tough one, not like the tiny plastic modern era. Okay, so let's check. I have another screw here. Okay, so that's it. You see. And now, okay. Kind of easy. Wow. So, there's the old type of manufacturing the notebook. So you have an Intel 6230, and this this fan, it only blows to the case, to that radiator. That's crazy. Okay, so that's what's this is from here. This was not a plug-in. We have here that's not a battery, that's an accumulator, nickel metal hydride. So it's going beneath mainboard. Okay, so let's put this, but I don't think it's this. Just flex. Okay. Actually, customer said it's working, and in one morning, it's not working. So, I think on this flex says sound, and I think sound was not working. Let me take out this DVD. But this DVD, I have to take out this two screw from here. And ta-da! this DVD don't have cover. You know, you see? This crazy, crazy, crazy. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, the same blinks. No change. Okay, so I have to take out. First, take out the wireless. And then take out this sound flakes. Take out this another flakes cable. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. And then we have keyboard. I think it's glue with double adhesive tape. Hope it works to come out beneath, but we'll see. Let's take out the fan, which has maybe the single screw. They are meant to unscrew with a bigger screwdriver. Okay. Let's take out. Leave this cable. It will go in up. Okay, it's not slide up. Okay. And I think the screw from radiator from CPU. They are going through the main board. Let's see. Okay, so someone was change the thermal paste already. Because was not clean best around the CPU. You see, in this side, thermal paste remaining, but that's not a problem. But take a picture for customer. Okay. With a laptop who was working another person, another guy in him, you may get may have a surprise, because a changing a thermal paste only a screwdriver escape on one CMD piece, it's enough to get the laptop defective, and not all the customer they are honest and say, yeah, I try to change thermal paste and not working anymore. Simply it's say to you, last night work, today in the morning is not working. It's a simple. So that it has to look a clean CPU with no thermal paste on him, no residue. And let's see, we have screw one in here, so this is from CPU. Let's see, we have here flex floor LEDs and the flex floor yeah, what, that's crazy. So the touchpad going to the this LED and click no, it's going from to the motherboard of LED with LED, and from this going to the mainboard. Another screw in here. Take out the power supply. And here we have another flex. I think this is from mainboard. So I have to take out with care. So, of course, we have here on the VGA out, we have two big screws who go from 2 years from structure of laptop. Okay, now it's up, and so we have here another flex cable. That's a tiny one, but where is this going? I think this is, this flex is for touchpad, and this tiny for LEDs. Anyway, so I have wire from LAN. Okay, and now free flex. And that's the main board. Okay. Let's clean and then check for faults. Okay, so I'll be back after I do some measure and that's a human hair, long hair. And I'll get back to you with updates. Okay. And after some visual inspection, I found beneath this sponge some oxide. Okay. I'll show you. You see? That's oxide. So I'll clean, I'll recheck, I'll put down, take out all the sponge and see if we have another issue on the main board, and I'll back to you.